basic thing to expect when you get a municipal job. It's outrageous. Okay, so horrible report. The survey was done with actual workers and actually compared to 1,000 others in this survey methodology. It is what it is. It was leaked to the media. Who knows if we would have ever seen this thing? But here's the response from the chair of Public Works. So this is the political head who oversees this department. Councillor Sam Marula, chair of Public Works Committee, reacted strongly, calling it fiction. Okay, so 300 people are surveyed, and the results are terrible. And the political person in charge of that committee calls the survey fiction. Loren, what did you think when you saw that?
I think that councillor and all councillors need to be very careful so that we don't end up being sued by survey companies who are very reputable that we hire by impugning the results that are presented. Right. That's right from the get-go. We don't need to be
getting into another lawsuit?
Right. And first of all, if this is leaked and has not officially come out and there is no staff report to explain it to council, then don't comment on it.
Well, staff were scrambling all over, sending out messages that it's, you know, essentially tough medicine, but they have to take it, that all feedback. I mean, they asked for this survey, right? They paid, our taxpayers paid for this survey. It talked to people. I mean, there's quantifiable research and there's qualifiable research, as you know, Loren. This, I would think, would be in the qualifiable side of it, right? Where it's talking about experiences, it's more anecdotal, you can't necessarily attribute numbers to it. And so this survey are people who spoke to these survey people and told them what they told them, and now it comes out and the reaction is that it's fiction. So not only do I agree with you, you're dismissing the integrity of this survey company and its process potentially, but what are you saying about these workers who spoke to a city hired consultant?
So they're liars, I guess.
Is that something that the chair of Public Works should be saying about people who participated in a city public works survey?
If Councillor Marula is right and this survey and the results therein are fiction, we've got an altogether different problem that city workers are trying to sabotage the city.
All 300 of them in cahoots somehow, right? Right.
I don't know.
It's total nonsense, and it's a lack of leadership. It's a lack of leadership to ask for something, hear the results. You don't like the score of the game, so you try to change the rules after the fact. It's absolute BS. I'm calling BS on this move, Sam, and on the motion, which just passed through committee going to council. Here's Sam's motion. Plans to introduce a motion putting a moratorium on surveys that he says aren't based on a scientific formula that creates a margin of error. The Denison model, which is this survey methodology, involves surveying workers on more than 50 points, then comparing them to about 1,000 other organizations to reach a percentile. He's calling this method not scientifically sound. So I guess Sam Marula has some sort of degree in survey methodology or something that would make him more expert than the Denison model, which the city hired to do it. I don't know.
So the methodology is absolutely scientifically sound. What isn't scientifically sound is you're dealing with people's opinions rather than fact.
Right.
But that's what you asked for from the get-go.
That's the kind of survey that was being done.
Yes.
And so to label it fiction, I think it's pretty outrageous, and I think it sends a message to, and there are other comments that he made, I just don't have capture of them, but yeah, brutal. So here's the thing. The chair of the committee that is supposed to be fixing this gigantic, or at least overseeing this gigantic departmental mess, gets results back and totally dismisses them or tries to, and I don't think it worked. And I think it's pretty embarrassing. So if you're gonna really try to fix a problem, if you're really gonna try to take an evidence-based approach, if you're really gonna do all the good stuff we've been hearing the city manager say, and we've obviously been hearing that a lot of it doesn't seem to be working so far, when you get back some actual scientific methodology, you accepted the methodology going in, you get back results you don't like, they're terrible, but own up to it and try to fix things. Don't try to tell us that the survey itself was bad. And don't try to tell all those workers who participated, probably some of them even fearing retribution, they still did it. And now they're being told that it's fiction. It's outrageous to me.
Maybe we just shouldn't have asked for the survey to begin with.
Hey, if you want to put your, if you want the management style where you just stick your head in the sand like an ostrich and hope that everything works out, fine, do that. Mm. But you can't have it both ways. You can't be telling us and everybody else that you're fixing this ginormous mess, and then when you get back one of those tools to help fix it, you dismiss the tool because you don't like it. If counselors actually accept the committee's motion to essentially, put a moratorium on surveys, they're sending a signal that they are discarding the evidence on a seriously damning survey. And I think that just pushes our council even further back. If you want to be evidence-based approached and you're going to try to convince us you're fixing this giant problem in public works, then at least own up when you get bad results, all right? Okay, let's get to issue number three. There is, you talk about Ockmar. You know the building better than I do, I think, Loren.
Sure, Ockmar.